Hello everyone, my name is Azariah Tan, and I am a concert pianist from Singapore. Today, I am delighted to be part of Kris Foundation's Digital Concert, a new initiative of digital 30-minute curated online programs. Today, I'm happy to present Brahms' Opus 116 Fantasies, and this work is a combination of seven short piano movements, which are entitled either capriccio or intermezzo. In this context, capriccio refers to a more fiery, energetic, strong character, and intermezzo is one of more tender, gentle, and slow character. Opus 116 was composed towards the end of Brahms' life, when he was about 60 years old. During this time, he sent many of these piano scores to Clara Schumann, so she could be considered the secret dedicatee of this work. Now, as many of you know, Clara Schumann was the wife of Robert Schumann, and both of them were close lifetime friends with Brahms. When Robert passed away at a younger age, Brahms continued his deep friendship with Clara, and in fact, the friendship was a romantic one, but it never materialized into marriage. We could describe their relationship between Brahms and Clara as a bittersweet love. And for me, this piece, Opus 116, highlights that feelings that Brahms had for Clara. In fact, some of the unique features of this piece bring that up in a very touching way. For example, we have beautiful expressions but tinged with regret, with pain. For example, Brahms goes, so a beautiful expression but tinged with pain, and yet longing. And then we also have lots of duets between a lower male voice and a higher female voice. So listen up for that. Now, interestingly, Brahms unites all seven movements of this work by providing several common themes that run through each and every of these movements. And one of that is the motif of a descending third. And we get that right from the very opening piece. And every movement has this descending third, whether some form or variation. Another unique feature of this work is how Brahms uses a musical device called Rückblick, which means a backward glance or nostalgia. And within each of these movements, Brahms adds this Rückblick so that we as a listener, we subconsciously feel how the movement itself is connected. Brahms takes musical fragments from the movements and puts them, summarizes them, if you will. So as you listen to this piece, look out for the bipolar contrast of character, the fiery, the passionate, and the tender and gentle. Listen out for the duets, the conversations, the dialogues that take place between Brahms and Clara. But most importantly, enjoy the musical journey that Brahms intended.